What's up, guys? It is a beautiful fall day in San Francisco, and GoPro just released this, the Hero 8 Black. This is the first of two new products this year. The other is a 360 camera called Max, but this is the flagship. Now, a little history. GoPro's made Hero cameras for well over a decade, and they used to look like this. Now, think about the heroes we know. Firefighters. They need a lot of protective gear to go into a burning building. Well, the old GoPro had this big protective housing and this snap-on screen. The Hero 4 finally got the screen built in. Then the Hero 5 was waterproof so you could ditch the housing, but you still needed this frame to mount it anywhere. Well, folks, the time has come. GoPro should have called this the superhero because it can fly around in nothing but a cape. It's got these little fingers that fold down and attach to all your mounts. Now, on this camera, they actually seem to wiggle a little, but that's with me pulling on it, so maybe not really a problem when you're using it. That is the most obvious difference. The camera's just a lot less bulky without that frame on it, and it's also just smaller. You notice the lens doesn't stick out nearly as much. Flip side is, now you can't pull the glass off and replace it. GoPro swears this is the toughest glass they've ever made, and if you do break it, and you subscribe to GoPro Plus, they'll just give you a whole new camera. So, let's turn it on. First thing you'll see is this bright, beautiful screen. They've done a lot in software to make it easier to use. Right down here, they have these presets. You can make a whole bunch of these if you want. These basically change all your settings for different shooting situations, so a lot less time fishing around in the menus. Then there are these four buttons. This one controls your slow-mo, this one's for zoom, and this one's what they call digital lenses. This changes your field of view. There's super view, which is like in your face, super wide angle. Wide is the classic GoPro look. Linear gets rid of that fisheye distortion, and narrow, that's meant to look just like a smartphone camera. And by the way, all these modes work in vertical too, so if you're big on Insta stories, GoPro's got you covered. Now, then there's this button. It's stabilization, and that's another big new feature. Last year, they brought out Hyper Smooth with the Hero 7, and this is Hyper Smooth 2.0. So GoPro showed us this camera a few weeks ago, and they took us on a bike ride.
You're comparing the 7 and the 8.
Yes, this 7, it's 8.
And basically, this new stabilization soaks up whatever bumps you can throw at it.
What's better about it?
The stabilization.
Stabilization?
Yeah, Hyper Smooth 2.0 is amazing.
Now, if you're a mountain biker, you might want your video a little bumpy, so you get to control how much smoothing you get. But for the absolute most, you hit this button, which is Boost. Now, Boost narrows your field of view, so you have to be more careful with how you point the camera. But this is actually good enough to get rid of footsteps, so the camera just looks like it's gliding along. And look at this, I was on a scooter and the handlebars were all over the place, but the video just looks like it's floating. Now, another big deal is that finally you can use HyperSmooth in slow motion, and that is shockingly useful. Now you can fly around the dog park like you've got wings on and still catch that epic moment with the Frisbee. Also great for just holding the camera when you don't have a good place to mount it. I mean, as far as I know, there's not a GoPro mount specifically for cornhole, but here it looks like I brought a tripod, which is great because I did not bring any throwing skills. By the way, slow-mo is surprisingly good in low light, so if you're dying to share your beer pong skills with the world, this might be the camera for you. Now, one of the coolest features needs a little help from the GoPro app, and that's horizon leveling. We've all done it. You mount this thing on your helmet or your handlebars, you think it's straight, but it's actually totally crooked. But this thing's got sensors inside it, so it actually knows which way is up. And once you get the video into your phone, you can just press a button and it'll straighten out the entire clip. Now, maybe you don't want to record your whole 2-hour bike ride, because I don't want to watch that. But what you might want is a time lapse. GoPro's tried to take all the work out of that with auto time warp. You just swipe over to time lapse mode, make sure it's on auto, and hit record. What this does is look at a bunch of stuff like how fast you're moving, how much action there is, how much light there is, and it decides automatically how often to record a frame. Now, if there's a dramatic moment right in the middle, just press this real-time button to slow it down, and then it'll go smoothly right back into your time lapse when it's done. So those are the big features. There's other stuff too. Better quality on still photos. And now when you shoot a photo, you can have it capture a 3-second video at the same time. And you'll notice they've moved the GoPro logo. That's to make room for this, GoPro's first front-facing microphone.
The Hero 8 is built for a changing world where vloggers are walking around talking to their audience like this. Not only does the video have to be smooth, you have to be able to hear every word.
Now, we didn't get to test the Media Mod. That's a snap-on accessory that'll have an even bigger microphone. But the built-in one is already a big improvement.
I didn't even break a sweat. Now, the camera, on the other hand, it's on its third battery. so it's been sweating pretty hard.
So I'm gonna say the mic is an optional accessory. A spare battery, that's mandatory. So that's a quick look at what's new with the Hero 8, and they'll be selling this for $399.